Well, hello there, my dear friends. Welcome back to another gore-filled episode of the Scott Reproject. So today we are going to be making a black pudding. And yes, I've already done two black pudding videos, but this one's totally different. Today we're going to be making a baked black pudding. Now, this recipe is from about 1954, so another step back in time, and I'm quite looking forward to this because there's a few new ingredients going into it which I normally wouldn't put into my black puddings. And obviously it does exactly what it says on the tin. We're not going to put it into skins. We are going to put it into loaf tins and we're going to bake it. So what have we got? Right, let's have a spin round. First, we got this lovely, lovely blood, which we'll measure out. Beautiful, fresh blood. You can obviously use the dry blood. If you get onto Weschenfelder Direct, I'll put the link down in the bottom. There the kit is. They will get you what you need. They actually do a black pudding kit. And the beauty of this baked black pudding is, obviously, you haven't got to get a sausage machine, and then stuff it into cases. Just mix it up pretty quick and then get it into tins and bake it. Right, what have we got? So the star of the show then, 2 pints of blood. Then we've got 1 pound of suet. If you notice here, there is no lumps of pork fat. This is a genuine recipe and they use suet. So 1 pound of suet. We've got 8 ounces of pearl barley. Beautiful pearl barley, I love it. 8 ounces of rice, as you can see there. I've got 4 ounces of oatmeal and then the rusk. Now, with this being a baked black pudding, it'll have a more firmer texture, which is good. And that's what the rusk does. And then on to the magical seasoning. So we're going to use 20 grams of salt. I'm going to use some of this fantastic Droitwich salt from just down the road. Cracking quality salt. I've got 10 grams of ground coriander, 10 grams of dried sage, 10 grams of ground mace, and 10 grams of white pepper. So I think what we'll do first, we'll get all our seasoning blending. And as per usual in all my other videos, you give this a good mix until it's all one uniform colour. I'll weigh out my salt in a minute and get that in. But black pudding predominantly got a little bit of heat to it, a little bit of spice, which comes mainly from the pepper. So 20 grams, that's 21, we'll go with that, of wonderful salt. I'm just going to break it down a bit because obviously it's lovely crystals. And the old pestle and mortar. A lovely label. They've only just started reproducing this again. And it's just the best. Excuse the camera shaking. That'll do for me. Let's get that in there. And that is our spice blend. So we give that one more mix before we add it in. Let's have a smell. Ah, smells of black pudding, which always helps. So next then, what we need to do, as per the packet instructions, cook our rice and our pearl barley. But through the magic of camera, look at that, hey? So, cut rice. We're going to get that into our container. And then obviously our pearl barley goes in. Give that a bit of a mix up, loosen it. A Next to that, we're going to add our fresh blood. Look at this. It's just a beautiful thing. 1 pint. Crimson gold. Oh, the milkman only left one. Just had it handy. So, in with our second pint of blood. Beautiful. Looks like a scene from Dexter. I'm a blood spatter analyst, but I like mine cooked. Beautiful, beautiful colour. Rock and roll. Next, it's in with our suet. Tell you what I do, because it's always covered in flour. Just get the worst off. Get it in. Wow. How good's that looking? Next, it's in with our seasoning. So like I said, this is a recipe from early 1950s. So again, nearly 70 years old. Make sure I don't get blood all up the kitchen. Next, I'm going to add in our oatmeal. So classic ingredients so far: rice, barley, oatmeal. And then we're going to add a little bit of rusk. Now the recipe calls for 1 pound of rusk, but I'm going to be a bit intuitive. You know, I want it to firm up a bit. So we'll put a bit in, give it a bit of a mix, and see where we are. So, just shake it in. Let's give it about half, I suppose. Give it a mix. So like I said then, I am using fresh blood. It is quite hard to get hold of nowadays. You can use pigs, ox, lambs if you want to. If not, like I said, you can get that beautiful dried Dutch stuff. Works just as well. Just click on the link for Weschenfelder and they will sort you out. Right, get a bit more in there. I mean, I should put it all in, you know, be true to the recipe, but you know, I think that's looking pretty groovy. Okay, here's the crazy bit. I'm going to try a bit of this just to check out the seasoning. So ride your motorcycle down to the railway bridge and hang off. And let go, Michael. You're one of us. You're one of us, Michael. Tastes bloody amazing. Okay. We'll get it into tins. I've got dried sage in my teeth. Put that beautiful looking bowl of gore over there. Just greasing some loaf tins, or you could bake it in a deepish oven tray, roasting tray, whatever you want to call them, baby. Put a bit more in there and get our black pudding mix in. That in there. Oh dear, what a time the 80s were, hey? What a film that was, Lost Boys. I even forgive them for the cover of People Are Strange by The Doors. That's a random comment. So like I said then, adding that rusk, this makes it firmer. Great, you could take this out, you'll have a lovely block a black pudding. You can do a perfect slice, and that rust will make sure it holds together. Just gonna get a little bit more in there. Nothing wasted, proper nose to tail. So what I need to do, get some foil over these beautiful, beautiful coffins of blood. And then I'm going to put them in a bain-marie, which is just a posh word for a roasting tin full of water. Then get them into my oven, which I've got preheated at gas mark 3, 170 degrees centigrade. I'll put the conversion up there, honest. And then we'll cook them for 2 hours. Do these two first, then we'll make up a last one with what we got left in the bowl. Everything's good in the hood, baby. One put in. Let's get some boiling water around this one. That'll do. Hello, come into the light. Good night, sweet prince. So just keep an eye on the water level in them and let them do its thing. Right then, my friends, after 2 hours in the oven at gas mark 3, 170 degrees C, you take them out. You let them cool completely and they look like that. Proper, proper job. Look at that. You could build a house with that. That's a brick of black pudding. Just a bit of cement. So, just remains for us to cut a bit and cook a bit. Should we have a look, see what it looks like? Have a look-see. Get a little bit of light on the situation, because that looks like just one slab of midnight. Looking good though. So remember, this is baked black pudding, not stuffed into cases. Just have a look at that. So before any of you so-called aficionados say that doesn't look like black pudding, this is a proper recipe from a butchering handbook from 1954. So yes, this is proper baked black pudding. You can see the rice and the pearl barley. I suggest we just get it in the pan. What do you reckon? Or should we end the video here? Ah, no, okay, we'll cook a bit. So as you may remember, if you've watched this video all the way through, I did two black puddings to start with in the big tins and I had a little bit of the mix left. So what I did, I decided to get some pork back fat and put it in with the mix, and this is what occurred. Have a look at that beauty. Hey? The lovely pork fat, again, pill barley and the rice. And all I did was cut some small cubes of back fat, blanched them in hot water. Well, brought them to the boil, blanched them for a couple of minutes. That keeps the fat nice and white. And then I just mixed it in with the mix and got it in the tin. So yeah, two beautiful pieces of black pudding. There is only one accompaniment to food like this in the UK, HP sauce. It's just the finest. Right, let's not muck about now. Let's have a bit of that black pud to start with and that brown sauce. Look at that. Wow. Can I tempt you? If I can, that is a quintessentially English fork of food there. That's England on a plate, that is. God, I'm really enjoying this. What a terrible life. When you haven't got a wife, and the man next door's got two. Okay then, let's sum this video up before I get a bout of indigestion. Because I so want to finish that. So if you like what you've seen here today on the SRP, please click subscribe when my face comes up in this corner. Also check me out on my social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram at the Scott Ree Project. And please do, if you want to help the channel along, check out my Patreon page. But yeah, this was truly outstanding. An original recipe, an original recipe, my God, I'm getting worse, from 1954, baked black pudding. And it's stonking. Open up, go on. Can you get that? Take care, my friends. One great big slab of midnight.